Okay, so today we will discuss about transport process. Okay, and there are two major type of transport: active transport and passive transport. Okay, so we already know that the cell membrane plays an important role in transport of molecules. Okay, that's why we need transport system in the cells. Okay, and other thing we already know that the cell membrane or plasma membrane act as a semi-permeable barrier that
sir आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
अच्छा, आवाज बिल्कुल नहीं आ रही. आ रही?
नो सर,
आवाज नहीं आ रही. ओके ओके ओके. ज्योति, आवाज आ रही है? अच्छा अच्छा, आ रही है. ठीक है, ओके. So we have to say that plasma membrane or cell membrane act as a semi-permeable barrier. Okay, and why semi-permeable? Because it allowing only specific molecule to cross. Okay, and while other molecules cannot cross the cell membrane. Okay, that's why the cell membrane act as a semi-permeable barrier. Okay, and electron microscopic examination of cell membrane also revealed that development of lipid bilayer, which is also termed as fluid mosaic model, and the model consists of phospholipids. Okay, so as per fluid mosaic model, the plasma membrane composed of phospholipid, and phospholipid is a bipolar molecule as it has both polar part, that is hydrophilic part or toward the head side, and other part is okay. Baki to ek second, Jyoti, awaaz aa rahi hai kya? Shashi?
Yes sir.
Acha, विजेता, आप या तो हेयरफोन ईयरफोन लगाओ, है ना. मुझे लग रहा है आपने ईयरफोन नहीं लगाया है ना, तो इसलिए आपको आवाज़ ज़्यादा नहीं आ रही है. आप ईयरफोन लगाओ, है ना. आप हो सकता है डायरेक्ट मोबाइल के वाई ऑडियो से आप सुन रहे हो, है ना. तो आप एक बार ईयरफोन लगाओ. ठीक है विजेता. सो these phospholipids are aligned tail to tail. So the nonpolar area from a hydrophobic region between the hydrophilic head on the inner side and the outer surface of the membrane. Okay. So जो hydrophilic region होता है वो कहाँ होता है? Inner side. Okay. And this phospholipid alignment, that is tail to tail. Okay, and tail, we know that is hydrophobic. Okay, so membrane is hydrophobic inside and hydrophilic outside. Okay, so that's why it acts as a semi permeable barrier. Okay, now come to the transport process. Okay, so we know that there are two major types of transport: passive transport and active transport. Okay, and passive transport means to move particles from area of high concentration to area of low concentration. Okay, so this is very simple type of transport. Okay, so it is clearly indicated that in this type of transport, particles moves from high concentration to the low concentration. Okay, so this process of transport does not require energy. Okay, and this type of transport occur due to the concentration gradient. Okay, and the second type of transport is active transport. Okay, and active transport means particles move from the area of low concentration to the area of high concentration. Okay, so this is the reason why the active transport require energy. Okay, so obviously when the particles move from the low concentration toward the high concentration, it require energy. Okay, because this is not a physical condition. Okay, so when the when this type of transport occur, it definitely require energy. Okay, so these are the two major kind of transport. Okay, now we already discussed that the active and passive transport are two main biological processes which plays an important role in supplying nutrients, okay, and water, oxygen and other essential molecule to the cell. Okay, and even both active and passive transport works for the same cause. Okay, but with a different movement. Different means one movement from high to low concentration, and in other type of transport movement from low concentration to the higher concentration. Okay, and active transport require chemical energy because it is the movement of biochemical or movement of molecules from area of lower concentration to the area of high concentration. That is why it is require energy. Okay, and in the passive transport, we know that molecules move from the area of high concentration to the area of low concentration, so it does not require energy. Okay, and the movement of molecule across the cell membrane, pumping the molecule against the concentration gradient using ATP, okay, and it's called active transport. And the movement of molecule from low concentration to higher concentration, which means that they move against the concentration gradient. Okay, so any time when the molecule move against the concentration gradient, it must require energy in the form of ATP. Okay, and the movement of molecule within and across the cell membrane, and thus transporting it through the concentration gradient without using ATP, is called passive transport. Okay, because this is physical condition. Okay, and the movement of molecule is from higher concentration to lower concentration, which means they move along the concentration gradient. Okay, along means it doesn't require any kind of energy. Okay, so if now the next part is types of passive transport. Okay, so we call any type of transport which doesn't require energy in the form of ATP is called passive transport. Okay, so for example, first is diffusion. Okay, so this is very simple type of transport. Okay, in which water molecule, liquid molecule and lipid soluble substance can pass through the plasma membrane by the diffusion. Okay, so so this is called diffusion. It doesn't require any type of carrier, and it doesn't require any type of channel, any type of channel protein or any types of energy. It doesn't require anything. Okay, so the how the movement is take place? Movement is take place from higher concentration toward the lower concentration. Okay, now the next is facilitated diffusion. Okay, so in the facilitated diffusion, okay, the process is same. Okay, but it requires channel protein. Okay, द मूवमेंट ऑफ लार्ज और चार्ज मॉलिक्यूल वाया मेम्ब्रेन प्रोटीन. ओके सो द ओनली डिफरेंस बिटवीन द डिफ्यूजन एंड फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन इज द चैनल प्रोटीन. ओके सो इट रिक्वायर्स चैनल प्रोटीन फॉर द ट्रांसपोर्ट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल. ओके बट द ट्रांसपोर्ट अगेन टूअर्ड द कंसंट्रेशन ग्रेडियंट. ओके सो द प्रोसेस ऑफ द मूवमेंट ऑफ मॉलिक्यूल अक्रॉस द सेल मेम्ब्रेन via special transport protein that are embedded within cellular membrane is called facilitated diffusion, or another name of this type of diffusion is carrier mediated diffusion. Okay, and many large molecules such as glucose which are insoluble in lipid and too large to fit into the porins, that is small pore, therefore it will bind with a specific carrier protein and the complex will then be bonded to the receptor site and move through the cellular membrane. Okay, so this is called facilitated diffusion. Okay, now third is osmosis. Osmosis. Okay, so several times we have to discuss this part, that is osmosis. Okay, so osmosis is the movement of water molecule. Okay, but here is a point is that the transport is toward the concentration gradient, but it requires semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so this is only the difference between the diffusion and facilitated diffusion and osmosis, because osmosis require semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so osmosis is the type of diffusion of water molecule across semi-permeable membrane. Okay, so another point we have to focus here, the most of the time there is solvent flow across the semi-permeable membrane, and solvent particularly water flow across the semi-permeable membrane from a solution of high water potential, means high water high water this side high water potential hai, okay, and to a region of low water potential. Okay, if we talk in terms of concentration, so here flow of water from the lower concentrated solution toward the higher concentrated solution until the concentration of both the solution become equal. Okay, so this is the criteria in this process. Okay, so a cell with a less negative water potential will draw in water, but this depends on the other factor like solute potential, okay, and sometime pressure potential. Okay, but the simplest term, osmosis can be defined as the movement of water molecule from the low concentrated solution to the high concentrated solution. Okay, so ye aapka osmosis hai, yahan par aapka flow kahan hota hai, low concentrated solution se high concentrated solution ki taraf. Okay, now next is types of active transport. Okay, types of active transport. So active transport we already discussed, that involve movement of ion, movement of molecules, okay, against concentration gradient. Okay, so this is the difference between the passive transport which occur toward the concentration gradient. Okay, and if transport occur against the concentration gradient, that means from the low concentration toward the high concentration. Okay, so in this case the transport require energy. Okay, and energy require either in the form of a direct means, that is direct use of ATP, or by the indirect means. Okay, so here we have to remember this. If direct use of metabolic energy require to mediate transport, okay, So this type of transport is called primary active transport. Okay, if transport doesn't require direct ATP hydrolysis and direct requirement of metabolic energy, okay, but it involves coupling of molecules with another moving molecule along an electrochemical gradient. Okay, so यहाँ पर condition क्या है? अगर डायरेक्ट एटीपी रिक्वायर हो रहा है सब तो उसको बोलेंगे प्राइमरी ट्रांसपोर्ट. ओके, अगर एटीपी की तो रिक्वायरमेंट है बट डायरेक्ट ट्रांसपोर्ट में नहीं है, है ना, इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल ग्रेडियंट डेवलप करने में है. ओके, तो व्हेनेवर द इलेक्ट्रोकेमिकल ग्रेडियंट एस्टैब्लिश्ड बाय द यूज ऑफ एटीपी हाइड्रोलाइसिस और बाय द यूज ऑफ मेटाबॉलिक एनर्जी, ओके, आफ्टर दैट द ट्रांसपोर्ट अकर. ओके, सो at that time this transport is also called active transport because the electrochemical gradient established only after the use of ATP. okay, so this type of transport is called secondary active transport. okay, so yahi aapko samajhna hai ki primary active transport kya hota hai aur secondary kya hota hai. agar direct ATP ka use ho raha hai, theek hai, tab to hum isko bolenge primary active transport. lekin agar direct ATP ka transport nahi ho raha hai tab hum isko kya bolenge सेकेंडरी एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट. ओके, ये जो इस फिगर में भी आप देख सकते हो, आप द फर्स्ट टाइप इज दैट कैरियर प्रोटीन्स. ओके, सो कैरियर प्रोटीन बाइंड टू स्पेसिफिक मॉलिक्यूल्स एंड मूव देम फ्रॉम एन एरिया ऑफ लो कंसंट्रेशन टू एन एरिया ऑफ हाई कंसंट्रेशन. ओके, सो दिस इज वन टाइप ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट. ठीक है, यहाँ पर क्या हो रहा है, ट्रांसपोर्ट तो लो कंसंट्रेशन से हाई कंसंट्रेशन की तरफ ही हो रहा है. ओके, लेकिन उसमें हेल्प कौन कर रहा है, कैरियर प्रोटीन. ओके, कौन हेल्प कर रहा है, कैरियर प्रोटीन. जैसे कि आप फिगर में देख लो, ठीक है, ये कैरियर प्रोटीन है. ठीक है, और ये कैरियर प्रोटीन यूज हो रहा है. ओके, किस कंडीशन में यूज हो रहा है, कि मोलिक्यूल को लो कंसंट्रेशन के हाई कंसंट्रेशन की तरफ ये क्या कर रहा है, मूव कर रहा है. ओके, so this kind of transport is also called active transport. okay, because here transport occur from the low concentration to the high concentration, and in this type of transport there is you direct coupling of ATP used, or you can say the direct utilization of ATP take place. okay, now the second is endo cytosis. okay, so endocytosis means a large particle are engulfed by a portion of the cell membrane. okay, and the membrane then break off and travel into the cell carrying the large particle with it. okay, so yahan par kya ho raha hai, यहाँ पर आपका लार्ज पार्टिकल, जैसे कि एज यू सीन इन द फिगर. ओके, दिस इज दिस मेम्ब्रेन फॉर्म सर्टेन डिप्रेशन, एंड दिस डिप्रेशन एंगल फॉर द लार्ज पार्टिकल. ओके, एंड व्हेन द पार्टिकल एंटर इनटू दिस वेसिकल्स. ओके, सो दिस वेसिकल कैन क्लोज and the membrane now break off. okay, and this particle, this large particle now reach inside the membrane. okay, so this type of transport is called endocytosis. okay, now endocytosis has two types. okay, the one is phagocytosis and another is pinocytosis. okay, so when the particle that engulf by the cell membrane or plasma membrane is a solid food particle, so at that time the term used phagocytosis. okay, and when this particle which engulf by the portion of plasma membrane or cell membrane, if it is liquid, so at that time the term used pinocytosis. okay, so phagocytosis is used for the solid particle engulf, or pinocytosis is used for the liquid particle engulf. okay, now Now, primary active transport, also called direct active transport, and in this type of transport, direct use of energy to transport molecules across membrane. Okay, for example, sodium potassium pump. Okay, which use direct ATP for the maintenance of the membrane potential. Okay. So said sodium potassium pump is very good example of primary active transport. Okay. Now the secondary active transport. Okay. And secondary active transport also called co-transport. Okay. And this type of transport used energy. Okay. But in contrast to primary active transport, there is no direct use of ATP. Instead, the electrochemical potential difference established by pumping out of the cell by the use of ATP or metabolic energy. Okay, so that's why this is called secondary active transport, because energy is required but not directly. Okay. So the secondary active transport is again various types. So the first type of secondary active transport is antiport. Okay. So antiports mean there is transport toward the opposite direction. Okay. So in antiport, two species of ion or solutes are pumped in opposite direction. Okay. So at that time the term used antiport. Okay, so this, for example, एक molecule तो अंदर आ रहा है और एक molecule बाहर जाता है. Okay, same time. Okay, so this is called antiport. So one of these species is allowed to flow from high to low concentration, which yield the entropy energy to drive the transport of the other solute from a low concentration region to a higher concentration. For example, sodium calcium exchanger work as a antiporter. Okay, which allow three sodium ion into the cell. Okay, to transport one calcium out. Okay, so three sodium ion कहाँ आ रहा है? Cell के अंदर आ रहा है. और at the same time one calcium cell के बाहर जा रहा है. Okay. So this is a very good example of antiport type of transport. Okay, this is a secondary type of transport. Okay, and the second type of secondary active transport is symport. Okay, so in the symport, uses the downward movement of one solute species from high to low concentration to move another molecule uphill from a low concentration to a high concentration against its concentration gradient. Okay, so यहाँ पर आपको जो transport हो रहा है, ठीक है, वो किस तरीके से हो रहा है? That one solute species from high to low concentration. Okay, so this is a very normal type of transport. This is toward the concentration gradient. Okay, but another molecule at the same time transport uphill from low concentration to the high concentration. Okay, but point is that both molecule transport at the same side. Okay, like in antiport at the opposite direction, but in the symport both transport toward the same side. Okay, but the difference is that here the one molecule transport from high to low concentration and another molecule transport from low to high concentration. For example, glucose transporter, which co-transport one glucose molecule into the cell for every two sodium ion into the cell. Okay, so ye ho raha hai, matlab ek glucose ka molecule to andar aa raha hai, theek hai, uske sath sath do sodium ke molecule bhi kya ho rahe hain, andar aa rahe hain. Okay, तो इसको बोलते हैं सिंपोर्ट. ओके, सो द वेरी फाइन डिफरेंस बिटवीन एंटीपोर्ट एंड सिंपोर्ट. ओके, सो नाउ वी हैव टू रिवाइज द कंटेंट. हाँ, जोशीला, define what is passive transport.
Sir, in passive transport, the particles move from higher concentration to the lower concentration and zero.
And it require energy or not?
It doesn't require energy.
Why it doesn't require energy?
So because it is like it has already been moved from the higher concentration to the lower concentration, so there's
because this is toward the transport, toward the concentration gradient, not against. Okay. And what is active transport?
In this active transport, particles move from the lower concentration to the higher concentration.
Okay. And why it is this type of transport require energy?
Because it's not towards the concentration.
Because here the transport occur against concentration gradient. Okay. And what is diffusion? Diffusion. The transport of molecule, from higher concentration toward the lower concentration, without any use of any kind of energy. Okay, this is very simple type of transport, or the type of passive transport. Okay, and a water molecule, lipids molecule, lipid soluble substance can pass by this type of transport. Okay, and what is facilitated diffusion? And what is the basic difference between diffusion and facilitated diffusion?
So in diffusion, any particle can pass through it easily, but
the only difference is channel proteins. Okay. So in the facilitated diffusion, the transport occur toward the concentration gradient, that is from higher to lower concentration. Okay, but it requires channel protein. Okay, as you seen in the figure. Okay, and what is osmosis?
So it is the movement of water molecules from lower concentration to the concentration across the molecular membrane.
Correct. Movement of solute, from lower concentrated solution to the higher concentrated solution. For example, if there is two solution we have, one is 1 molar sodium chloride and another is 2 molar sodium chloride solution. Okay, when we separated these two solution by the semi permeable membrane, the water molecule from 1 molar solution transport toward the 2 molar solution until the concentration of both the solution become equal, that is 1.5. okay, so this is called osmosis. Okay, here the mandatory condition is semi permeable membrane. Okay, or and carrier mediated transport. Okay, carrier mediated active transport. Okay, so what is carrier mediated active transport? just opposite facilitated diffusion. Okay. The only difference is here transport from low concentration to high concentration. Okay, but just like facilitated diffusion, it requires carrier or channel protein. Okay. And what is endocytosis? Yes. Endocytosis is the type of transport where large particle engulfed. Okay. Engulfed. So here we use term engulfed. Okay. By a portion of cell membrane. Okay. So here if the engulfed large particle is solid, the term use phagocytosis. If it will be liquid, so term use pinocytosis. And what is primary active transport?
So, in this primary active transport, there is the direct requirement of ATP.
Correct, very good. Okay, if there is direct requirement of ATP, this is called primary active transport. Okay, or what is secondary active transport?
In this, there is no direct require, like there is no use or direct requirement of ATP.
Correct, correct.
Yeah.
Very good, very good. And what is antiport?
In antipode, the solutes of the ions are transported in opposite direction.
Correct. The main point is that transport opposite direction. Okay. For example, sodium calcium exchanger. Okay. Now symport.
There is the use of the downhill movement of one solid species from higher to lower concentration.
Correct.
Other molecule.
Correct. Okay, but transport air to the same side. Okay, like one glucose molecule transport into the cell and two sodium ion transport into the cell. Okay, so at that time the term used symport. Okay, very good. Shashi, Shashi, आप सुन पा रहे
हैं?
हाँ, तो अब देखें आपको कितना समझ में आया. तो पहले बताओ पैसिव ट्रांसपोर्ट क्या होता है?
ये पार्टिकल मूव होता है हायर कंसंट्रेशन से लोअर कंसंट्रेशन.
करेक्ट. और इसमें एनर्जी की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है?
नहीं.
करेक्ट. और एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट क्या होता है?
पार्टिकल मूव होता है लोअर कंसंट्रेशन से हायर कंसंट्रेशन.
करेक्ट. और एनर्जी की रिक्वायरमेंट होती है?
हाँ.
ओके, वेरी गुड. और डिफ्यूजन क्या होता है?
सॉल्युबल सब्सटेंस पास होता है प्लाज्मा मेम्ब्रेन के.
हाँ, हायर कंसंट्रेशन से लोअर कंसंट्रेशन की तरफ. ओके. और फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन क्या होता है? फैसिलिटेटेड भी डिफ्यूजन ही है, लेकिन यहाँ पर चैनल प्रोटीन भी इन्वॉल्व है. ओके, यानी ट्रांसपोर्ट हो रहा है लेकिन इट रिक्वायर चैनल प्रोटीन. जब चैनल प्रोटीन की ज़रूरत होती है, ठीक है, और ट्रांसपोर्ट चैनल प्रोटीन की हेल्प से होता है, तब इसको बोलते हैं फैसिलिटेटेड डिफ्यूजन। ठीक है शशि? हाँ,
सर।
ये थोड़ा सा डिफरेंस है, एक में चैनल प्रोटीन है और एक में डायरेक्ट ट्रांसपोर्ट है हायर से लोअर कंसंट्रेशन की तरफ। ठीक है, और ऑस्मोसिस क्या होता है?
वाटर मॉलिक्यूल का मूवमेंट
हाँ, तो वाटर मॉलिक्यूल का मूवमेंट होता है ये सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन के थ्रू, है ना। और वाटर कहाँ से कहाँ मूव करता है, एग्जाम्पल बताइए। जैसे हमने एक जो है 2 मोलर सॉल्यूशन लिया एक चैम्बर में, और दूसरे चैम्बर में हमने लिया 3 मोलर सॉल्यूशन, और दोनों को हमने दोनों के बीच में हमने लगा दिया सेमी परमेबल मेम्ब्रेन। तो वाटर कहाँ फ्लो करेगा, किस साइड से किस साइड फ्लो करेगा? बताइए, 2 से 3 की तरफ फ्लो करेगा वाटर या 3 से 2 की तरफ फ्लो करेगा?
2 से 3 के।
टू से थ्री की ओर, है ना। तो ऐसा क्यों होगा? क्योंकि 3 की कंसंट्रेशन ज़्यादा है। जब वाटर मॉलिक्यूल 2 से 3 की तरफ जाएगा तो थोड़ी देर बाद दोनों की कंसंट्रेशन क्या हो जाएगी, बराबर हो जाएगी। ओके, क्योंकि जिधर कंसंट्रेशन कम थी वहाँ से वाटर निकलेगा तो उसकी कंसंट्रेशन बढ़ जाएगी, और जिधर कंसंट्रेशन ज़्यादा थी उसके अंदर वाटर जाएगा तो उसकी कंसंट्रेशन घट जाएगी। तो थोड़ी बाद दोनों की कंसंट्रेशन कितनी हो जाएगी, बराबर। ठीक है, तो उसको बोलते हैं ऑस्मोसिस। ठीक है, और एक चीज और बताओ, प्राइमरी और सेकेंडरी एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट में क्या डिफरेंस है? प्राइमरी एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट और सेकेंडरी एक्टिव ट्रांसपोर्ट में क्या डिफरेंस है?
प्राइमरी में एनर्जी डायरेक्ट ट्रांसपोर्ट होता
हाँ, एनर्जी डायरेक्ट यूज होती है। ठीक है, और सेकेंडरी में? हाँ,
डायरेक्ट यूज नहीं होती एनर्जी।
वेरी गुड, है ना। तो यही है, और अब आप लोग क्विज अटेम्प्ट कर लेना। ठीक है, और जो आपका WT2 था उसकी डेट निकल चुकी है, उसको भी अटेंड कर लेना। ठीक है, ओके, थैंक यू।